for my next video, I'd like to do one on the Function Secure Folders. And I'm currently using my Samsung Galaxy S25 Ultra. This will work on any of the older Samsung devices. The only difference is I'm using the new One UI 8 Beta 2, and there are some differences between the newer beta, the new One UI 8 versus One UI 7. There's still some like ways about both of them. So if I show you the one, I'm pretty much going to be able to be showing you the other one. There's just a few more options on One UI 8, but I'm going to go through these and point them out when needed. So secure, let's just talk about this real quick. So secure folders is exactly what it says. It's a folder on your device, your phone, and it's secure. And it allows you now to also add in apps. So you can add in an app, you can add in your data, and you can, on One UI 8, you can fingerprint lock that, or however you want to lock it, completely and separately from the main lock. So in other words, and I'm getting a little bit ahead of myself here, but if you unlock your phone when you first boot your phone and you unlock it using your left thumb, you can set secure folders to unlock using your right little finger or whatever. So that's something we're going to get into and I'm going to show you. So let's just dive right in on how to turn this on and get it going first. So go into your settings, and then we're going to go and scroll down, and we want security and privacy, and then scroll down. And the next thing we want to go to is more security settings, and there's secure folder. So let's go ahead and open this up and get it going. So secure folder, enhance privacy, keep your sensitive apps and data in a separate protected area of your phone. You can set secure folder to hide apps and prevent notification when it's locked. Easy access when unlocked. When you unlock your secure folder, it is easy to move and share content. When you tap the share button in any app, you can choose to share using both personal app and secure folder apps. And then finally, hide secure folder for the most protection. When you turn off secure folder in the quick panel, the secure folder app icon will be hidden and all apps and data inside will be encrypted for maximum security. So it's a very powerful feature. It uses encryption. It makes it so you can't even see the folder when you're done. So let's start this. I hope it doesn't turn off my recording. So let's hit more. And I don't see anything. See some more. So permission for secure folder. Secure folder needs these permissions. So we'll set those, and we're right now creating secure folder, and you can read it while it's doing this. Add files easy. Easy access when unlocked. All right, cool. So I'm going to use a fingerprint, and we'll do a pattern. Let's see. For added security, before you can add your fingerprints, you need to set a secure screen lock, PIN, password, or pattern. So we need a PIN and fingerprints, password and fingerprints, or a pattern and fingerprints. We'll go with a pattern. And yeah, we'll draw it again. I'm not worried about anybody seeing this, because I'm just going to redo it. Okay, so remember it. You'll need to unlock your phone after it restarts and occasionally at other times to ensure your phone is secure. So continue. Fingerprints, a quick and easy way to unlock your phone and verify yourself in apps. Your fingerprint data is secured by Knox. We knew that. This is going to talk about that. So continue, and we'll register. And we're going to do this. And just kind of keep going here until it goes to 100%. Okay, so we got 100% on there now. Okay, so go ahead and hit, we could add another one, but for now, we're just going to use one. So we'll hit done. And allow lock reset within Samsung account. If you forget how to unlock secure folder, you'll be able to reset your PIN, pattern, and password using your Samsung account. Well, sure, why not? Because nobody else has it. So there we go. We'll hit, here's some options. Well, these were the ones with fingerprints added, allow lock. Okay, so we'll hit next. So now next, choose what happens when secure folder is locked. So we have two options. Close all apps while locked. Apps in secure folder will be automatically closed when secure folder is locked. Apps won't be visible and won't send notifications until you unlock the folder again. Or this one, allow background activity. Apps in secure folder will continue running while secure folder is locked. Apps in secure folder will continue sending notifications and may appear in the share panel and other settings menu. Okay, I probably would do this one. Close all apps while locked. Apps in the secure folder will be automatically closed when secure folder is locked. So we'll do that. We'll hit done. So choose what happens when secure folder is locked. So as you can tell, as I was doing this video, once I hit this section and I hit apply, it shut down my recorder and all my recording that I was doing. And I recorded about 5-10 minutes of video not knowing I wasn't recording. So anyway, I'm going to do a part two to this video. So this is part one for now. I'd like to do a part two anyway, because there's some things that the One UI 8 has that One UI 7 does not. So this is just kind of a getting started with your secure folder. And once I do the next video, it'll be more in depth of some of the different features it offers versus 8 versus 7. So my apologies for it shutting off. I should have stopped, but I didn't know that it would shut it off, and it did. It shut it off and rebooted even. So it just goes to show you it's a very secure thing when you're messing with this kind of stuff, encryption and that. And like I said, that got cut off. If you really, I probably am not personally going to use this. I know it's kind of a odd deal that I'm making a video on something I don't use, but some people might find this handy. I've taken a lot of schooling in encryption, and the best advice for encryption, if you want to keep something safe, simply don't put it on the device. So a lot of my files, I don't even have, if they're any kind of important whatsoever, I'm not going to put them on my Samsung and then use a secure method of securing them. I have other ways and means to do that if it's an important file. So, but everybody's different, and you can do this, of course, if you'd like. So I hope you found my video to be helpful. Thank you for being here. Please like and subscribe to my channel. Leave me a comment down below. Thank you for your time. And until next time, I'm out. And P.S., keep an eye out for part 2 to this video. I'll be doing that very soon. Thank you.